morning. What a beautiful song by our choir. What a beautiful lighting of the candle of peace this morning. If you're a visitor with us this morning, it's so great to have you in the house of the Lord with us. If you've never had an opportunity, we have visitors' cards in the pews, and we will be very discreet. If you fill out the visitor's card, we won't put you on any international mailing list or anything like that. It'll just be totally national and local. No, please, just take one of those visitor's cards. You can put it in the offering plate. You could press it into an usher's hand or into my hand. We'll shake hands at the door. It's just so good to have you with us today. God is at work today. And we even thank him for the gentle rains. It could be snow, you know. Okay. Amen. And that's a sign of age when you start not liking snow as much as you used to. Amen. 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 I spoke to the Zoranans last night. Brielle Hope Zoranan was scheduled to be baptized today, and instead she's in Children's Hospital right now. And she is 1 month old. And she is doing well. She's getting some strong medications to take care of a situation on her nose. It's called some big fancy medical name, but it's being resolved, and they just have to give this little baby some strong medication and watch her while they're giving it to her. And it's going well. I talked to mom and dad last night. And we need to continue to keep Brielle Hope in our prayers. And also, we're praying this morning for everyone gathered here, that God's will may be fulfilled in each of our lives. We remember that David is a man after God's heart. And the scripture clarifies that by saying a person after God's heart is one who does everything that God wants them to do. That exciting. God has a plan for each of our lives. And we pray this morning that his plan may be fulfilled. At this time, I'd like to call Susan Stone back. I could hear your gentle laughter before, but I couldn't see it. Now I see it. Susan just wants to give a very brief special message from our stewardship team. And then after that, we'll go to the Lord in prayer.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, like when I was up in November with emotional moment, I have some more questions. Thank you for sharing. It's just beautiful. But the steward from the stewardship committee and the outreach and evangelism committee, we had a wonderful trip last week, young and old and middle-aged. We were all out enjoying a wonderful visit with our friends at Cinnaminson Manor. And if you look in your dates to remember, there's going to be many other opportunities for us to go out and for us to bring people from the community in. And we have so many wonderful ministries at this church. And by our tithes and offerings, that's how we support these ministries. So we just ask you to continue to keep your offering and your giving and your prayers. And we just ask you to keep it in prayer. So thank you.
You know, one thing, we're in our series on the story, and we're learning about Solomon this week. And our tagline for our message is, don't miss God for this world. Solomon starts out strong and ends weak. And the stewardship message that the stewardship team wants to just give you today is, we need to have a strong December. That God wants us to finish strong, and there's so many things that our church does. And as Susan said, I agree with Susan to just be in prayer and how we may help the kingdom of God here at Asbury United Methodist Church finish strong at the end of the year. You have prayer cards in your pews. If you have a special request, please fill them out. Ed Sharp, head usher this morning, will bring them forward. We'll pray for them in Mass this morning. And then we pray for them each individually on Tuesday for our prayer and our Bible study together. It's so good to be in the house of the Lord. I always remember the way that one of my bishops would introduce prayer. He said, "Let us come before the Lord to the one who can really, really help us." This time I'd like to call Bill Smith, who's going to come forward and lead us to the throne of grace this morning. Amen.
Help us to be good examples and a light to the world. The only Bible that many people will read is us. And Lord, help us and prepare our hearts. In Jesus' name, I pray. And all God's people said, Amen.